Hey everybody, what I'm doing today is I'm going to be working on this guitar, and the first thing I need to do is I'm going to take the strings off. You have to take the strings off to do anything to it, so... Hey Daniel, welcome to the broadcast. What I'm doing here is I'm working on a guitar. And I'm going to be tearing it apart to start with. It's going to take some time, so I'm going to be doing this throughout the day. What I'm doing is I'm trying to, hey Marvin, how you doing? Let me move this light a little bit so you guys can see better. I'm tearing this guitar apart. What I'm going to do is I'm going to completely take all the hardware off of it, and I'm going to carve a dragon into the body right here. I'm going to make a 3D carving. It's going to be pretty cool when I get done with it. But right now I'm just taking the strings off. Which you know yourself, it takes a little bit of time. So I'm going to be doing this for a while anyway. What I should do is just cut the strings off, but I'm trying to save the strings. You know how that works, right? So I'm busy taking these strings off here. I'm trying to do is save these strings so I don't have to trash them. I'd like to reuse them. Because I just put them on here not long ago. Ouch! Just stabbed myself. That hurt. Alright, now, once I got the strings loose, now I can take the tailpiece off with the strings. Everything comes off, one easy swoop. Hey, thanks for the likes, I appreciate it. Appreciate it. And I'm gonna set this tailpiece aside. I don't want it in my way right now. But, how you doing everybody? Welcome to my broadcast. What I'm doing is I'm tearing this guitar apart. And for you that haven't heard yet, as I'm tearing this guitar apart, I'm gonna take all the hardware off of it. and I'm going to carve a dragon into the body, a three-dimensional dragon. It's going to take a little time, but if you fan me, you come back, keep checking my broadcast, I'll be working on it. So what I'm going to do is I want to loosen all the screws on the pickups. Now, a little suggestion. I found this out the hard way. It's best to find a little container to keep all your parts in, because your parts can be lost very easily. So I'm going to keep all my parts over here. That includes all my screws. These screws can be lost very easily. And if you notice, I do everything by hand. I don't like using tools to take screws out. And I'll tell you why, because tools are too powerful and they can strip the screw holes out. Do it by hand, it's easier. Better job too. Let me turn this music down a little bit. It's a little loud. There, is that better? You hear me better? Where's my other screwdriver? Is anybody still here? Anybody still here? Hello? Type 1 if you are. Okay, Marvin's here. Becca's here. Cool. I have to run and get a screwdriver. I'll be back in 2 seconds. 2 seconds. This is what happens during live broadcasts. It's not always predictable. But that's what makes live broadcasting interesting, because it's not predictable. Okay, and I'm gonna take these bridge nuts out of here. Hey, thank you for the likes, I appreciate it. Becca, are you a guitar player? Are you a guitar player, Becca? Now, in case you guys don't know, these nuts are bridge nuts. And what they do is they not only hold the bridge on. Yeah, it is like a drug, Marvin. But they hold the bridge on, and you can also adjust the height of the bridge if you choose to. And the reason you want to adjust the height of the bridge is because it adjusts the heights of the string off the neck and off the frets. Because the closer you can get to your frets, the better action you'll have when playing. Action means fingering, to use you guys that don't know what I'm talking about. No, Becca, I asked you if you were a guitar player. Are you a guitar player? I know, Marvin, you have a beautiful guitar. That Les Paul is awesome. I love that guitar. But you can see it's slowly coming together here. Well, actually coming apart. Now I gotta pull these knobs off of here. You do that very gently. You don't wanna yank them too hard, because you can damage your pots. These are called pots. Let me move this light. These are called pots, potentiometers. They control your volume and your tone in your guitar. All right, next thing I want to do is I want to finish taking all the screws out. Can you all hear me okay? Is my vocals okay? I'm not too glitchy or anything? Ginsog Barroom, queen in Memphis. Yeah. She tried to take me upstairs for a ride. She had me right across her shoulders. Thanks, Marvin. Just can't seem to drink her off my mind. Oh, and she's a honky-tonk woman. Mm-hmm. Gimme, gimme, gimme the honky-tonk blues. New York City. Kind of a fight. Me and roses. And then she blew my mind. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on my soldering gun here, get it heated up, because I'm going to have to knock a few wires off of some things here. Basically, I'm going to have to tear the whole thing apart. Hey, how you doing, Ahmad? How you doing, buddy? Hey, Ahmad. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker! Yippee-ki-yay! Now, you see my pickups, they're laying in there loose. That's what I want. So I'm gonna loosen all the nuts on my pots here. You like that, Ahmad, huh? Yippee-ki-yay! Bruce Willis in the house. I can smell my soldering gun heating up. She's a working. Now, one thing, if you guys are all guitar players, which I know Marvin is, you're gonna like what I'm about to show you. You're gonna be tickled pink over this. Just hold on a minute and I'll show you. Fast as you can. Everybody crazy about a sharp-dressed man. Ba ba ba. Awesome. Looks really interesting already. You like this, Becca? You never did answer me. Do you play guitar? Or maybe you did answer me and I didn't see it. Cause every girl's crazy about a sharp-dressed man. Okay, now that I have all the front basically disassembled, now it's time to go to the back. And this is what I was talking about. This is really interesting, so stay tuned. You're gonna like this. Now watch. Most guitars, the back panel covers, these are called panel covers, are put on with screws. Now since I build guitars, I invented something unique. Now I don't know if other guitar companies use this, but I do. I put magnets in my panels. See there? They're magnets, and they just pop right off. So I can just pop them right off. Saves a lot of time, effort, and you don't strip out the wood all the time with the screws. How about that? Isn't that cool? How do you like that wood? Isn't that wood pretty? You like that wood? That's curly maple. Actually, it's tigered maple. All right. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start knocking the wires off of stuff. Actually, I don't need to knock the wires off of this one because I'm not going to be working up in this area. I'm just going to be working basically on the bottom of the guitar. So I'm going to take all the pots out. Actually, second thought, I really don't need to disconnect the wires either. I can just take the pots out and lay them aside. What do you think, Marvin? You think that'll work? I think it'll work. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to lay them in here. They'll be out of the way. They won't be poking up through the face of the guitar. Am I crazy to say that? I really want to have a third humbucker in my Bigsby. You know, a third humbucker would be awesome, Marvin. I did that to a Les Paul one time. A customer brought in a guitar and he wanted me to put in a third pickup in it. And the third humbucker really kicks butt. If I was you, I'd go for it. But have somebody professional put it in, unless you know what you're doing yourself. If you know what you're doing yourself, go for it. Okay, here we go. By the way, hi Sonia, welcome to the broadcast. I'm working on a guitar here. I build guitars. Well, second thought, I am gonna have to disconnect my pickups. Yeah. I'm gonna have to disconnect my pickups, so I am gonna have to knock out some wires. Because these pickups will be in the way. All right, so that's easy enough. So here's what I want to do. I just want to knock the wires loose for the pickups. And with the pickups, there's usually two wires, so it's not a big deal. So here we go. I'm going to take these two wires. I need to remove the red one. Can y'all see? I'm gonna move the red one and I'm gonna remove the black one off of the pickups, or the pods rather. So here we go. Try not to burn myself. Okay, I got them wires off. Sorry if y'all can't see very good, but this is very delicate work here. Now, with pickup wires, there's usually, like I was saying earlier, there's usually two wires. Ouch. There's usually a hot wire and a ground wire. There we go. Now, a hot wire and a ground wire, like I was saying. The ground wire connects on the back of the pot, the volume pot, for anybody that's interested. The hot wire is connected directly to the terminal on the pot. So I'm going to pull these pickups through. See how easy they came out? Lickety-split, how about that? Put them in my parts. Now, if you ever take pickups out of a guitar, and if they're not labeled, which a lot of them aren't, you can save yourself a lot of headache when you go to put the pickups back on the guitar. Here's a little shortcut. If you notice, these pickups, they have the pick guard. Now, there's the neck pickup. That's the neck pickup. Here's the bridge pickup. Now, what do you notice different about those two? This is a little hint for you to help you reassemble your guitar without a headache. Okay, the neck pickup, the pickup frame or guard, whichever you want to call it, is usually thinner than the bridge pickup. See how much thicker the bridge pickup is? That's a little hint for you. Saves you a lot of headache down the road. Okay, I'm gonna put these pots back in here. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn it back over. Now I'm going to take the strap nut off of here, because it may be in my way as I'm working. Now, if you're all interested, I have a YouTube channel. My YouTube channel is All Shook Up, where I do a lot of videos. Hold on a second. Am I losing my viewers? Why can't I get this out of here? Can't get the screw out of here. Oh, there we go. I might have to put a little bit of super glue in the screw hole when I put it back on. I think this screw hole's a little stripped out. But it's not a big deal. Just a drop of super glue fixes it. Boy, that baby's really in there. There we go. Alright. Now that that's done, okay, so now that I have the hardware basically disassembled, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the design of the dragon right here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off my broadcast here. Nobody's watching me anyway. I'm going to cut off my broadcast and I'm going to find a picture of a dragon that I want to put on here. Then I'll duplicate the picture of the dragon onto my guitar. Is anybody still here? If not, that's cool. Alright, y'all have a good day. I'll come back on after I get the picture of a dragon to put on. Alright, later.